everybody, welcome to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And this is wrestling the way I want it and the way I like it. Joining me here for color commentary, the newly ordained commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Mr. Jim Cornette.
That's exactly right, and today you picked a great time to tune into Smoky Mountain Wrestling because we're going to see highlights of the match at SummerSlam between the Heavenly Bodies and Rick and Scott Steiner. We're also going to have a baby bonnet match today where the Suicide Blonde Chris Candido says he is going to take that bonnet off his head. And we're also, and I can't wait for this, going to have videotape a Bullet Bob Armstrong facing my secret weapon, and I can't wait for it. And Down and Dirty, I know, is going to be exciting today, Dutch.
Well, we've had some controversy recently, but I'm going to be talking to Tammy Fitch, Primetime, Brian Lee, and Ron Wright today on Down and Dirty with Dutch. But right now, it's Draw, the man who's going to face the Beat the Champ right here. And I am going
to
let... I want you to draw a name, Mr. Commissioner. Mr. Commissioner, we'll draw the name right now.
Who is going to face Robert Gibson? I'm the commissioner. I can do this. In the Beat the Champ. Who is going to face Robert Gibson today in the Beat... Who's going to face Robert Gibson today in the Beat the Champ? Who is going to face Robert Gibson today in the Beat the Champ? The Dirty White Boy is the name that I picked to face Robert Gibson today for the Beat the Champ TV title. Okay. And I did it fair and square.
Absolutely. Okay, let's go to the ring right now, fans.
Fans, this is your first match for Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Introducing, weighing in at 235 pounds, from Raleigh, North Carolina, Robbie Eagle. And introducing from Ashland, Kentucky at 228 pounds, he is the current United States Junior Heavyweight Champion, Bobby Blaze.
Okay, fans, our first match here, opening match here, Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Bobby Blaze, who claims to have won the United States Junior Heavyweight title in Columbus, Ohio in recent weeks. Now, I checked that out, and there may be some validity to that, but I'm still not fully convinced that he did win the tournament, Jimmy.
Well, I did some checking into it also, Dutch, and he did win the tournament. I found that out, but the thing is, it was a big-time wrestling promotion, big spectacular, but they had names like Bobby and Jackie Fulton and some of the other junior heavyweights across the country that like to wrestle by the rules and nobody to really get in there and go and grab a tournament, because you got to go out there and take a tournament. And I guess Bobby Blaze just kind of fell into it, United States Junior Heavyweight title.
Well, he's in the ring right now against Robbie Eagle. Now, Robbie Eagle, an amateur champion in his own right, a big hip toss by Bobby Blaze. And, Jim, for the fans at home, you know, my job sometimes is to sit out here and delve in behind the scenes. How does it feel to be the commissioner of a major wrestling federation like Smoky Mountain Wrestling?
Well, believe me when I say this, Dutch, it's lonely at the top.
I can imagine that.
It's a dirty job, but somebody's got to do it. And if all the lights stay on and none of the fuses blow, I think it's going to be great. I'm going to make a lot of changes here, and I'm going to make a lot of things, more comfortable for you and me, Dutch. And I'm going to say something. Last week, you know, this Bobby Blaze, this punk in here, he's getting a little big for his britches. He and Chris Candido had some words, and I know now they have a title match signed at the Parade of Champions coming up in October. Bobby Blaze and Chris Candido for the United States Junior Heavyweight title, and I'm looking forward to seeing that because Chris Candido will hand this punk's head to him. I can see that right now.
Well, good move right there by Robbie Eagle. Now, to be the United States title holder, Bobby Blaze doesn't look really superly impressive at this point in the match.
Well, I'll tell you what Blaze's strength is. He's so stupid, he doesn't know when to quit. That's the thing with the Dirty White Boy. Everybody saw it. He would not give up. He won't quit. He entered that tournament, and he told everybody, "I was surprised I won."
Of course he's surprised.
Well, I would be too, but he just goes in there and he won't quit. And sooner or later, somebody knocks themselves out trying to beat on him. Well, I'll tell you something right now. Blaze going to Robbie Eagle. But at the Parade of Champions, we're going to find out if Bobby Blaze has what it takes to take on Chris Candido. And you know, two count. You can find out more, Dutch, when you call Info Connect, your voice information system. They'll be providing schedules of matches for Smoky Mountain Wrestling fans. You can dial the number you see on your screen, 615-581-1233, extension 2021, to find out about upcoming matches like the Parade of Champions, going for a belly to back. Blaze sits out, reverses, goes in, belly to belly. Oh, Northern Lights suplex. Northern Lights suplex. He got him. I can't believe it.
Bobby Blaze.
Fans, here is your winner of the match.
Smoky Mountain
the United States
the
Junior Heavyweight Champion, Bobby Blaze.
And we hear the ring announcer, Brian Matthews, announcing Bobby Blaze the winner here and the first match here of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Okay, joining me here at the broadcast booth, the WWA World's Heavyweight Champion, the Suicide Blonde, Chris Candido. Now, Chris, you've had some words with Bobby Blaze. Do you intend to stand by and take it, or what is your plan of action at this point?
Just to tell you, my plan of action is to take that lousy cheap hubcap off his waist that should not be recognized by Smoky Mountain Wrestling. It's not a real championship like mine is a real championship. I'm going to take that belt at the Parade of Champions, and not because I want it. At the Parade of Champions, I'm going to beat Bobby Blaze within an inch of his life, take that belt, and throw it in the river. But then, just as importantly, right here on the show, I'm going to have a match, and I plan on getting this bonnet off my head once and for all.
Would you people shut up for a second? I can still hear you breathing. Chris, I tell you what I'm going to do. To make sure you get a fair shake today with this thing on your head, I'm going to be the special referee. I'll be the special referee just to make sure it's fair and square down the middle. Yes, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Commissioner.
Thank you.
There you heard it. Jimmy Cornette, special referee today on Smoky Mountain. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Good move, Mr. Commissioner.
Well, thank
Good
you.
Good move.
Thank you very much.
Smoky Mountain Wrestling presents, as part of the Johnson County Apple Festival in Paintsville, Kentucky, the Big Apples Raffle, Friday, October 1st at the Paintsville High School. The biggest card of wrestling ever in Paintsville. Both men will have a 3-foot leather strap. In a grudge match, the Rock and Roll Express battle Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies. The tag titles are on the line as Scott and Steve Armstrong challenge the Bruise Brothers. The heavyweight title will be up for grabs as Southern boy Tracy Smothers tries to regain the title from primetime Brian Lee with his manager Tammy Fitch, and the Dirty White Boy will be in a cage at ringside. The main event at the Big Apple Grapple is Apple Brawl 93, a 13-man battle royal. The winner will receive $5,000, but the last man eliminated will be tarred and feathered in the middle of the ring. As a special bonus, Jim Cornette will be appearing in the Apple Brawl. It takes place in Paintsville, Kentucky at the Paintsville High School. Friday, October 1st, bell time 8 p.m. for the Big Apple Grapple.
If you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
Welcome back, fans of Smoky Mountain Wrestling and newly ordained Commissioner Jim Cornette.
And you know something, Dutch? I want to share with everybody a little piece of videotape concerning the old commissioner,
yeah.
Bullet Bob Armstrong. When he met my secret weapon in Johnson City, Tennessee, he wasn't a big caliber bullet. He was a little bitty pea in a little bitty pea shooter, and now he's all the way out of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Take a look.
And now against the ropes. Here comes the Black Ninja. Look out, nobody home. Nobody home. And again, the Black Ninja feeling a little pain in the squared circle. Into the ropes he goes. Here's a sleeper. Bob Armstrong has a sleeper. Wait a minute, Cornette's into the ring. Loading that tennis racket. Mark Curtis takes it away from him. But Cornette's in the ring. And Bob Armstrong getting some free shots. Cornette is down. Whoa, Cornette, a hard right to the jaw. And now Armstrong has the sleeper on Cornette. It could be nighty-night for Jim Cornette. Armstrong has Cornette down, and the Black Ninja looks like he doesn't know where he is. Now Armstrong to the Black Ninja, taking them both on. Cornette might be out. Cornette looks like he is out. Mark Curtis trying to revive him. Meanwhile, Armstrong now going to work on the Black Ninja. The Black Ninja, wait a minute, what's this? Here's a second Black Ninja. Am I seeing double or what? Look out! Armstrong is down. What's going on here? The Black Ninja, number two, is in the ring. And Mark Curtis is counting. Two, three. Wait a minute, wait a minute. What has happened here?
this second Black Ninja, and the referee doesn't realize what has happened. But the second Black Ninja has entered the squared circle and pinned Bullet Bob Armstrong. Jim Cornette escorting this new Black Ninja from ringside, and Bob Armstrong has been counted. Shoulders to the mat, three count. Oh my, there's the official announcement.
So as everybody can see, not only did Terry Funk win the commissionership of Smoky Mountain Wrestling for me by beating Bob Armstrong, but then my secret weapon eliminated Bob Armstrong completely from Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Everybody thought when they saw that secret weapon, they said, Jim Cornette's crazy. But I proved it. I was crazy like a fox. I know you didn't, Dutch, because you got faith in me. And now Bullet Bob Armstrong is back at the Jiffy Lube in Marietta, back at the Exxon station on the corner in some part of Jerkwater, Georgia, with his sons pumping gas and lubing cars and sweeping out people's toilets and doing manual labor like that instead of bothering people in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. He's gone, and he's gone for good, and I can't wait see to see the look on all these redneck morons' faces around the area when they realize that their hero, their savior, their idol, the great Bullet Bob Armstrong, ain't coming back because Jim Cornette eliminated him from the picture. Right, Dutch?
Absolutely. Don't go away, fans. We'll be right back with more of us because we can come back,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, we can come back anytime we want to, but he can't.
Wrestling fans, keep in mind that Smoky Mountain Wrestling will be seen here on Your Mountain Television, Channel 57, next Saturday, October 2nd at 11 a.m. due to University of Kentucky football. Cumberland, Kentucky, Cumberland High School. We're coming there on Saturday, October the 16th, 8 p.m. with two title bouts and a battle royal in Cumberland. Meet the Rock and Roll Express in Barberville at the new Marathon Pit Stop on the Parkway, Thursday, October the 7th from 3 until 5 p.m. And don't forget the Big Apple Grapple in Paintsville at the high school, Friday, October the 1st at 8 p.m. The main event is Apple Brawl 93. The Parade of Champions is coming to two locations in Kentucky. Check this out. Hazard, Kentucky, Memorial Gym, Thursday, October the 7th, 7:30 p.m. Barberville and Knox Central High School, Saturday, October the 9th at 8 p.m. Gold Circle ticket holders in Barberville, come out at 6 for a party with the stars, courtesy of Subway, free food and drinks and autographs of your favorite Smoky Mountain stars. It's a number one contenders match at the Parade of Champions. Tim Horner against the Dirty White Boy for the heavyweight title. Primetime Brian Lee with Tammy Fitch taking on Tracy Smothers with sensational Sherry Martel. Also, it's a grudge tag match. Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies taking on Rick and Scott the Steiner Brothers with their pit bull Arnold. And also, you're going to see a Smoky Mountain tag title match. The Rock and Roll Express, the new Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions, taking on Scott and Steve Armstrong. Now, what we're going to do now is bring in Ricky Morton and Scott Armstrong. Guys, it's kind of ironic that you're taking on your friends here for the tag titles.
It is ironic, Brian. And, you know, Steve and myself had title shots with the Bruise Brothers. We were the number one contenders at the time. And all of a sudden, the night before our first title shot, Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson win the titles. Well, hey, you know, if Steve and myself can't have the belts, then I can't think of a team I'd rather have them, Ricky, than you and Robert.
Well, thank you very much. But, you know, there's not another tag team in the country today, bar any of them, that deserves a title shot no more than you and your brother do.
Appreciate that.
But, you know, during this match right here, we don't have to worry about Jimmy Cornette coming behind us with tennis rackets. We don't have to worry about the Bruise Brothers out on the floor switching. But one thing we do got to worry about, it's going to be a hard-fought match. And, you know, when this match is over, I hope we can shake hands and walk out.
We can.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm joined here by Jim Cornette and the Heavenly Bodies, and I think everybody needs to stand up and give them a big round of applause right here. Thank you, Jimmy, for being here with me. Let me ask everybody a question. What time is it? It's time to see how the Steiner brothers, Rick and Scott Steiner, ripped us off at SummerSlam. I finally convinced those stingy, tight WWF officials to let loose of a piece of the videotape. They were ashamed and embarrassed to have the people around here see how we got ripped off in Detroit, so they didn't want to let go of the tape. But finally, I got a copy of it. So I want you to roll that videotape right now. Steiners and Heavenly Bodies from SummerSlam in Detroit, Michigan. And I got some things to say after it finishes.
Thus far, with the exception of the outset of the matchup, I guess it's pretty safe to say the Steiner brothers have been having some fun in there. Oh, look at this.
Well, so did the Heavenly Bodies at the beginning.
I said with the exception of the outset.
That's what I meant.
Off the rope now! Pritchard over! Jimmy Del Rey gets one as well! There's only one thing left, and that's to give one to Jim Cornette! Off the rope! Oh, look at that! Uh-oh. What a team! What a team! Cleverly done by the Heavenly Bodies. Nonetheless, there were two of them in the ring, should have only been one.
Can you imagine the disgrace, McMahon,
of
being beaten in your hometown, your home state, in front of Momsey and your sister? Oh, it's going to be horrible.
It can happen. Anything can happen here in the WWF. We know that for sure.
And it usually does.
The Heavenly Bodies, look, what a maneuver!
A moonsault!
Did you see that on the outside? I've never seen anything like that before. Unbelievable. That'll take it right out of you. And no doubt.
Real quick.
Yes.
The Gigolo's going up top.
Jimmy Del Rey going up to the top rope now. And Steiner's going nowhere. Oh, my, except down on his knees, down to the canvas. What a maneuver by Gigolo, Jimmy Del Rey.
That moves on
to the outside. Unbelievable. And unquestionably has taken its toll on Scott Steiner. Off the rope now, reversal.
Oh, my back. Whoa. Titles are going to Smoky Mountain. I can feel it. Isn't it ironic that the colors of Michigan would be yellow?
And blue.
But mostly yellow.
Look at this. They're not yellow. They're gold, Bobby. And oh, down with a knee to the back of the head. And the Heavenly Bodies really pouring it on. The Heavenly Bodies coming very, very close now. You feel unquestionably the momentum of the matchup shift back in favor of the Heavenly Bodies.
Well, it's gone that way since the beginning, back and forth. But I'm going to have to give the edge to the Heavenly Bodies just on points. My point system puts them 1,112-9.
What kind of a point system is that?
My point system.
Hard right hand block there. It's doubtful that anyone can take the Steiners on. In the fisticuff department, here comes Gigolo, Jimmy Del Rey. Oh, my, rams the knee to the back of the head. Unbelievable.
But I noticed that Scott Steiner is face down. He don't look too tough right now.
Scott Steiner being set up off the rope. Oh, devastating maneuver by Del Rey.
The disgrace of Michigan.
There's the cover. 1, 2, and no. Almost a count of 3. That was close. That was close.
A heartbeat away. A half a heartbeat.
Jimmy Del Rey tagging his partner. Thus far, they've done a great job of keeping Scott Steiner from tagging his brother Rick. They've cut the ring off on him time after time. The Heavenly Bodies have.
They certainly have. And the Heavenly Bodies, they get more dates than a calendar.
Oh, did you see that?
No, I missed it.
Referee's back was turned. Did you see that?
You want a Diet Coke?
I have my
head turned. What happened?
He just nailed him. The racket, I mean, he really, Jim Cornette, I can't believe.
Cornette hit someone with a, no, don't
get yeah,
me.
Right, yeah, that would never happen, right?
I can't see it happening.
Tom Pritchard coming in now. And again, you see the job the Heavenly Bodies are doing on Scott A. Steiner, trying to keep him away from tagging his brother Rick. Frequent tag back and forth with the Heavenly Bodies. The strategy of Jim Cornette paying off. Steiner has to tag his brother Rick.
Come on, J.O. Jimmy.
The defender successfully defend the title. Look out. And again, cut right off.
Isn't it amazing? Rick didn't want to tag his brother.
Yes, he did. Look at
that. Oh, no.
And another suplex. That took a great deal out of Scott Steiner as well.
But the doctor has enough poise and presence to make a tag.
And again. And Jimmy Del Rey, the tag is going to be made. Yes!
No!
Scott Steiner with Jimmy Del Rey. Oh, my! That's Rick Steiner, rather, mowing him down.
Mrs. Steiner just gave her daughter a clothesline. They're all nuts.
Look at that,
Spoopy.
Unbelievable action for the tag team title. Look out! Look at this. From the top rope, he walked up backwards, bulldogging down to the canvas.
He's done everything in his life backwards.
Hey,
why wouldn't he climb the ropes backwards?
Pritchard saving his tag partner from being pinned. But on the receiving end of this. Meanwhile, back in the middle of the ring, and now, a cover here, Jim Cornette's up. Goes in the racket. Look out, ref, turn around. Oh, my, did you hear that? Did
you hear that, Bobby Heenan?
Heavenly bodies.
Don't go. Don't win it this way. No, no. Two, three, no.
Steiner Brothers love. Come on. Get him. Get him. They had it. They had it, McMahon.
Unbelievable kick out by Rick Steiner.
He's going for that reverse moonsault.
Look at this. Look at this.
Going up to the top. Yes. On his own tag team partner.
Oh, no. He signaled for the Frankensteiner.
Off the road.
Oh, man.
Wow. Gentlemen.
Okay, you saw it, Jimmy. What do you got to say about it now?
How did you cheat us? Let me count the ways. First of all, they had a hometown advantage, Detroit, Michigan. Oh, everybody knows the Steiners are from Detroit. Everybody knows the people in Michigan are mentally defective, just like these idiots here. Secondly, they had a referee from Detroit who was obviously swayed by the fact that the Steiners were wearing the colors of Michigan, one of which is yellow. Then they had 20,000 fans there screaming their lungs out so that the boys couldn't hear my signals. And finally, watch that last piece of that match. Both Steiners made the cover to pin Jimmy Del Rey, and the referee counted it anyway. But we did not lay back. We didn't take it. We didn't leave it sit there. No, we jumped in on another WWF TV taping. And we gave the Steiner brothers a little taste of what the Heavenly Bodies can do. And I want you to see that piece of videotape.
The most dominant tag team in World Wrestling Federation history. The Steiner brothers win it here. Man, they have been fighting champions. They've taken them all on. Hey, wait a minute. Here come the Heavenly Bodies. Here come the Heavenly Bodies and Jim Cornette. The Heavenly Bodies told the Steiners they hadn't seen the last of them. Whether Cornette's got some powder or something in his hand, and this gets Scotty around the eyes. Scotty Steiner being blinded, and then clubbed that racket by Cornette. The Heavenly Bodies double teaming. Oh, my! They're double teaming Rick Steiner. Cornette is using that racket as a weapon. There's absolutely no reason for this. What a cowardly act. The Steiner brothers successfully retain the tag titles, but now they're being battered. They're being assaulted by the Heavenly Bodies. Scotty Steiner still blinded. There goes the referee outside. Hey, wait a minute. Cornette starting to pick up the belts. Another tennis shot right to the sternum. What a chaotic situation here. What a cowardly act by Cornette in the head. Wait a minute. Those are the WWF tag team title belts. They don't belong to the Steiner, to the Heavenly Bodies. They belong to the Steiners. What a terrible situation. The Heavenly Bodies and Cornette will pay when the Steiner brothers get their hands on them.
Heavenly Bodies, what we did to you in Detroit, our hometown in SummerSlam, is just a small taste of what we're going to do to you down in Smoky Mountain. Because Jim Cornette, I still have those welts on my back. And I just had to take that powder out of my eyes. So when we get down there, we're going out for blood.
Cornette, you got a thing with the racket. Well, I tell you what, get in the dog pound and find out what a real mad dog can do when he gets a hold of you, Cornette. Wait and find out.
Jim Cornette, I'm going to use that racket on you.
Now, you see, the Steiner brothers were left laying face down, flat of their faces in the ring. They were beaten up, broken, and disgusted. And now they say they're coming down to Smoky Mountain Wrestling at the Parade of Champions to get some revenge. Well, as you saw in the last little piece of that videotape, we took their belts. Of course, the WWF caught us at the back door, made us hand them over, said they'd call the cops because we stole something. Yeah. That's real selective thinking about stealing things. But then the very next match that the Steiner brothers wrestled, they lost the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team title. Because we took so much out of them. Because the Heavenly Bodies beat them up so bad. They had their minds on the Heavenly Bodies. They couldn't think about anything else.
They lost their belts, they blame us. And now they're coming down to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. We'll have to parade of champions in October. Steiner Brothers, you're going to find out that anything can happen in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. You're not going to be namby-dambied and pambied and coddled like you are up there in the bright lights in the big city. It's rough down here. And we know that all the fans are universally all across the country behind you, whether it be Michigan or Tennessee or anywhere else. We realize that. But, brother, I got news for you. We don't care what the fans think and never have. So you come on down to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. The only thing that I'm upset about, like I've said before, is that mangy, flea-infested, disease-ridden pit bull Arnold that you're planning on bringing to the ring. But I guarantee you this, Steiner Brothers, one of these guys is going to take that pit bull and defang it once and for all at the Parade of Champions. It's going to take place, Dutch.
Okay, Steiners, when you step in here, you're going to step into a hornet's nest. We'll be right back, fans. Don't go away.
They'll learn, Jimmy. They'll learn.
Get a ration.
Coming in October, Smoky Mountain Wrestling presents the Parade of Champions, a super spectacular card featuring the top stars in the world of wrestling. The main event is a grudge tag team match with Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies, doing battle with former WWF tag team champions Rick and Scott the Steiner Brothers with their pit bull Arnold in their corner. Primetime Brian Lee with manager Tammy Fitch will defend the heavyweight title against Tracy Smothers, accompanied by sensational Sherry Martel. The tag team titles are up for grabs as the Rock and Roll Express defend against Scott and Steve Armstrong. In a battle to determine the number one contender for the heavyweight title, White Lightning Tim Horner meets the Dirty White Boy. The newly crowned United States Junior Heavyweight Champion Bobby Blaze defends against the Suicide Blonde Chris Candido. It's a star-studded lineup of the greatest champions in wrestling. Smoky Mountain Wrestling is now offering official merchandise by mail. You can have the excitement of Smoky Mountain Super Shows like the Volunteer Slam and Fire on the Mountain on videotape. All the weekly SMW TV shows are available on home video, custom made to your order. Be fashionable with SMW t-shirts and baseball caps. Get an autographed photo of your favorite star. For a complete list of items, send a self-addressed stamped envelope to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, P.O. Box 1279, Morristown, Tennessee, 37816. Send for your brochure today.
Fans, this is a Baby Bonnet Challenge match. Introducing first, weighing in at 248 pounds, from anybody's guess, the Dark Secret. And introducing, weighing in at 224 and one quarter pounds from Asbury Park, New Jersey, the Suicide Blonde, Chris Candido. Here is your special referee for this match, Mr. Jim Cornette.
Well, fans, this is a match right here because between Chris Candido and the Dark Secret. And, of course, if Chris Candido wins, he can take that stupid, ridiculous bonnet off. But I think Jim Cornette, being the newly ordained commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, will change a lot of things around here, and he's going to change this. Oh, what a tremendous lockup right there. He's backing Dark Secret into the corner. Now, a lot of you people might ask, how can Jim Cornette be the referee? Well, he is the commissioner. He can do about anything he wanted. He fired Bob Cottle. I'm sitting out here. He gave me a raise. He asked me to put on a tuxedo, and I do look very sharp, if I might say so myself. Oh, a vicious lockup right there. Backseat, Dark Secret into the corner. And, oh, did he slap him hard? Oh, he locked a slap him. Oh, man, he is really laying on him now. He is pounding the Dark Secret. Jim Cornette, being the solicitous referee that he is, immediately steps in and says, are you hurt and do you want to continue? And, wait a minute, he picks him up, puts him down. What a tremendous body slam right there by Chris Candido.
What is this, Dutch? This is a travesty. Having Cornette as a commissioner now.
Now, Mr. Horner, I want to say one thing right now. You're taking your livelihood in your own hands. We have a new commissioner. You could be fined, suspended, and fired for coming out here unsolicited.
Well, look, Dutch. Look at this match. Obviously, this is a setup on the part of Candido, and probably Cornette's behind it.
Well, now that's in the eyes of the beholder. It looks like to me, really, it looks like Candido is really laying on the Dark Secret at this point in the match.
How can you sit here and say that, Dutch?
Easy. I just said it. It's easy for me to say. Look at there. The Dark Secret. I tell you, I think Jimmy needs to stop this match.
He shouldn't even been in the match to begin with. This match shouldn't even take place.
So what's
obviously
your
set up.
Are you saying you're disagreeing with our new commissioner?
I'm disagreeing with our new commissioner. He shouldn't even be commissioner.
Well, why do you say that?
Well, look at...
Look at there. Look. Oh, wait a minute. Let's go.
Oh, come on.
One, two, three. Oh, now Chris Candido can take,
fans,
can take the bonnet off.
Of the match,
and I believe
the suicide blind, Chris Candido.
Cornette is a commissioner. Chris Candido bonnet is off, and I think it was a good move on Cornette's part right there. Now, Tim, I know you have trouble with Candido, but let's not have a style greats rationale here. He won it fair and square. Hey, wait a minute now, Tim Horner, let me say.
That was the toughest wrestling match of Chris Candido's career, but he finally got that bonnet off his head. If you touch me, I'll fine you $50,000.
I told you.
I'd gladly pay the $50,000.
Whoa. I told him, Mr. Commissioner.
That was a legitimate match. There wasn't nothing wrong with it. And Chris Candido won, and he got that baby bonnet off his head.
You obviously set it up, and you were probably behind it.
Wait a minute.
What are you doing here?
Let me interrupt just a moment. Dutch, I'm here on behalf of the board of directors of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. They say that the television tapings can't continue like this, and I have some special correspondence here for Mr. Jim Cornette.
You've been promoted. How can you get any higher than commissioner? Have I been president, maybe?
Hold on, let's see here.
Dutch, help me read this, if you will.
We'll read this.
Board of directors, Jim Cornette.
Impeached? How can they impeach me? They can't.
No!
I'm the boss.
I can't be impeached.
I'm the boss.
No. 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 Oh, hey, Judge, shut up. Leave it alone. We'll be right back. We got to check this out. Jimmy, that letter say anything about me?
If you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
Okay, welcome to Down and Dirty with Dutch. I'm Dutch Mantel, and you're not. I'm still here right now, but I don't know for how long. But right now, before I get my special guest back here, let's take his special comments. Let's hear some special comments from sensational Sherry Martel.
You know, Tammy Fitch, they say you went to Wellesley College, and they say that you've been known to interfere a little bit with Mr. Brian Lee, and where his matches are concerned, saying that you give him some type of glove. Well, I myself have been known to wear a few gloves, Tammy. And you know what happens when the 4th of July comes about and New Year's come about all in one night? Well, that's what's gonna happen when I see you at the Parade of Champions, Tammy Fitch, because once I show you what wrestling's all about, the only damn thing you're gonna wanna do is go back to your little books and putting on your little bras, putting on your little stuff all over your derriere, strutting it around the ring, because when I get finished with you, you're not going to have anything left to strut. You're not going to bother anybody in Smoky Mountain Wrestling anymore, and I can go back to New Orleans again.
Okay, I got my special guest out here now. You heard what sensational Sherry Martel says. I'm nervous right now. Your comments right now.
You know, sensational Sherry is nothing but an ex-convict, reform school girl. Tracy Smothers has less hair on his legs than Sherry does. She's like a gorilla. She's not a lady. She's a man. She's a truck driver. And I hate Tracy Smothers. I hope he gets in an accident and he gets decapitated and his head rolls down the road and a truck flattens it out.
I'll tell you what, baby. Don't worry about an accident, because next time Tracy Smothers steps in the ring with me, it's going to be the biggest accident of his life.
Okay, but I know the fans, what they want to know, how is Ron Wright? Ron, how are you?
Well, I'm a feeling.
Ron is just fine. Can't you tell? He looks healthy. He's getting his medication on time. And he's just happy, aren't you, Tiger?
Yeah, but I wonder how Dirty White Boy is. I hadn't seen him in a while.
Don't worry about Dirty White Boy. He's doing fine. Come on. It's time to go read now.
Okay, fans, there we heard it from Tammy Fitz, Primetime Brian Lee, and Ron Wright. Don't go away. I'll be right back, I hope. Can I get impeached too?
Smoky Mountain Wrestling is now offering official merchandise by mail. You can have the excitement of Smoky Mountain Super Shows like the Volunteer Slam.
I
I'm Les Thatcher, and I'm going to be here for a while. How long, I don't know either. Dutch Mantel will be joining me in just a moment. But with me right now, that wild-eyed Southern boy, Tracy Smothers. And Tracy, for that big parade of champions, like you've got a fail-safe in Sensational Sherry.
That's exactly right. You know something, Les? I saw all that bunch out there, all that riff-raff last week. Looked like they's pretty tongue-tied to me. Didn't know which one was going to grab the mic, and they's out here a while ago. They didn't sound too much better. You know why? Because Prime Time and Tammy Witch, you're real worried, because I got Sensational Sherry Martel. That's right. All these people know her. She's known worldwide. She wrote the book on Dirty Deeds. And Tammy Witch, you come out here and you talk about these Southern girls. Well, these little Southern girls got more class in their pinky than you've got in your whole stinking body. Now, I know Sherry's going to take care of Tammy Witch. And Brian, I taught you everything you know, but I didn't teach you everything I know. And as for you, dirty white boy, I don't give 2 cents about your troubles or Ron Wright's troubles or the whole lot of you. All I'm concerned with is getting the Smoky Mountain Heavyweight Championship back where it belongs, and that's around my waist.
Tracy, good luck to you. You've heard from Tracy Smothers. Let's throw it to the ring and ready for our next match.
Fans, this match is a tag team match, introducing at a total combined weight of 436 pounds, Gator McAllister and Jason West. Introducing now at a total combined weight of 620 pounds from Sturgis, South Dakota, the former Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team Champions, Ron and Don, the Bruise Brothers.
The Bruise Brothers out here against Gator McCluskey and Jason West, and back with me, Dutch Mantel. And Dutch, it'll be you and I doing the color and play-by-play.
Well, you know, I told that Jimmy Cornette not to take it too dadgum far, because, you know, I thought he was doing that, taking that commissionership just a little bit too seriously. I told him not to do it, and I told him not to fire Bob Collins too, but he did.
Well, obviously, the board of directors felt the same way, because he is no longer the commissioner. But right now, we do have a match in the ring. And the Bruise Brothers, of course, talking about Jim Cornette. Envelope, Dutch. I have
Jimmy,
no way
Jimmy
of
said my name wasn't in it, so I'm pretty safe, right? You think?
Well, at least for the time being, we're both safe, at least through this match, anyway, Dutch.
Well, I told him not to fire call. Here we let's see the Bruise Brothers right now, but trying to get back on track to regain those Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team titles right now, and his name is the guy in the ring. They're beating up right now. Is not McCluskey. It's McAllister from Marsh Island, Louisiana. Made his debut on Smoky Mountain Wrestling last week, and now shoved you back in the corner. The partner, Jason West, coming in, but these Bruise Brothers are just too big and too strong for these young men.
They are very tough. And, of course, Jim Cornette is a bit upset with these guys for dropping those title belts to the Rock and Roll Express.
And fans, I want you all to stay tuned. Beat the Champ match up next. The Dirty White Boy taking on the title holder, Robert Gibson. That ought to be a pretty decent match.
I think it ought to be a barn burner. You know, you mentioned Bob Cottle just a moment ago, and I want to mention this. Bob is now vacationing in Europe.
Oh,
but
really?
He has been rehired by Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
I like him a lot.
And he will be back in a few weeks.
Oh, good. I really wish him back. I missed him a lot. I hated working out here with Cornette. You know,
a different tune you're singing, Dutch.
Oh, no. Cornette was a commissioner, and I just didn't want to make waves. A double kick by the Bruise Brothers. Down, both men go. Double count, double pin, double win for the Bruise Brothers.
Here are your winners of the match, Ron and Don, the Bruise Brothers.
Their way back to those Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team belts.
And we're going to talk.
Let's go right now and get an interview with the Bruise Brothers and our newly acquired announcer, Les Thatcher.
With me, the Bruise Brothers. And guys, you look like you were taking care of business. You were right on top of your game tonight.
It's like this. Me and my brother are the number one tag team in professional wrestling today. Jim Cornette, you said you were unhappy with us. You didn't like the way we were conducting ourselves in the ring. Well, baby, we just took care of business, and we should be the ones in line for the Rock and Roll Express for them titles again. We're the best, and we're here to prove it to you, Jimmy.
Top of the line right here. We got a point to prove. Everybody gets in that ring. We go smash them and pin them 1, 2, 3, because can't nobody do it like us. We the baddest things run. And like brother said, we slipped up just a little bit. But by God now, everyone who steps in that ring with us, we gonna make a point with you. We gonna use you as a toy. We gonna beat you worse than you've seen us beat anybody since we've been here in Smoky Mountain. Because Jim Cornette, we're here to prove to you we're still the best, baby.
Fired up Bruce Brothers. We'll be back with Beat the Champ right after this.
Wrestling fans, Smoky Mountain Wrestling will be seen on Your Mountain Television, WIMT, next Saturday, October 2nd at 11 a.m. due to University of Kentucky football. Smoky Mountain Wrestling coming to Cumberland, Kentucky at the high school Saturday, October the 16th, 8 p.m. Two title bouts and a battle royal in Cumberland. Meet the Rock and Roll Express in Barberville at the new Marathon Pit Stop on the Parkway Thursday, October the 7th from 3 until 5 p.m. Don't forget the Big Apple Grapple in Paintsville at the high school on Friday, October 1st at 8 p.m. The main event is Apple Brawl 93. The Parade of Champions is coming to two locations in Kentucky. We're going to be in Hazard with the Parade of Champions Memorial Gym Thursday, October the 7th, 7:30 p.m. and Barberville at Knox Central High School Saturday, October the 9th at 8 p.m. Gold Circle ticket holders in Barberville come at 6 for a party with the stars courtesy of Subway, free food, drinks, and autographs with the stars. You're going to see for the heavyweight title, Primetime Brian Lee with Tammy Fitch taking on Tracy Smothers with Sensational Sherry Martel.
You know, I can't stand Sherry Martel, but she'll fit in just fine with all those yucky Eastern Kentucky women. She's got a foul mouth, an ugly face, and more hair on her legs than a gorilla. Brian, please don't let her hurt me.
Darling, she won't put a hand on you. I'll tell you what, Tracy Smothers, you're hiding behind a woman, and you come out and tell Primetime Brian Lee he's hiding behind a woman, and you have nerve enough to call her a tramp. Well, I'll tell you what you need to do is go get you some glasses and find a real woman and see what a real woman looks like and quit lusting over mine. In Kentucky, Tracy Smothers, I'm taking you out once and for all.
Watch out, Bluegrass State. It's the Parade of Champions. You're going to see a grudge tag match. The Heavenly Bodies with Jim Cornette taking on the Steiners with their pit bull, Arnold.
Whether it's Hazard, Kentucky on October the 7th or Barberville on October the 9th, let me guarantee you something, Steiner Brothers. You bring that rabid, flea-bitten dog of yours, Arnold, that pit bull, you bring him to ringside. He ain't gonna bite me. I got something for Arnold. And then the Heavenly Bodies got something for you, Rick and Scott Steiner, big World Wrestling Federation stars. You lost those belts because of the Heavenly Bodies. When you come to Kentucky, you're gonna lose a lot more than your belts.
Fans, this match is set for one fall. It is for the Beat the Champ TV title. Introducing first the challenger from New York City, 252 pounds, the Dirty White Boy. And now introducing the current Smoky Mountain Wrestling Beat the Champ TV champion, 238 pounds from Pensacola, Florida, Robert Gibson.
We're ready to roll with Beat the Champ, and it is champion Robert Gibson putting it on the line against the Dirty White Boy. Dutch, should be a real good match.
Oh, it should be a real good match between Robert Gibson and the Dirty White Boy. Excuse me, I'm still a little bit nervous, you know, when you get letters, you know,
and pinching people and stuff, you know, sort of unsettling.
I understand. Nobody wants a pink slip. You're right, Dutch. I don't blame you.
But I'm okay, you think?
Well, as far as I know,
okay.
We're still here.
All right, let's get back in this match right here. Robert Gibson, of course. Now, just because, you know, I'm unsettled a little bit doesn't mean I can't say what I want to say while I'm out here. Robert Gibson last week stole the belt from Jimmy Del Rey. Just stole it. It was highway robbery is exactly what it was. Now, Dirty White Boy back in the ring today, and if he can take it, I think that might make him three-time Beat the Champ title holder. Dirty White Boy, of course, held it. A couple times, retired undefeated with it on one occasion.
As did Brian Lee.
Absolutely, and he is just a man. He is just a man to carry that $1,000 out of the ring today. Are you going to talk to Bob Caudill like this next week or something?
Well, not while he's in Europe, but may talk to him in the next couple
if
weeks.
If you do,
yes.
I mentioned his name and I ask about him.
All right.
Good man.
Certainly will
Real
do that,
good
Dutch.
Man.
Certainly will do that.
Oh, good, big, heavy. Heavy shots from the Dirty White Boy. Shoots Gibson in for the ride. Gibson alertly moves out of the way. Comes up with an arm drag and takes White Boy. But referee Mark Curtis making making Robert Gibson break the hold.
You know, that Mark Curtis, and I'm going to say one thing, he's escaped in this Smoky Mountain Wrestling Federation by the skin of his teeth. And if Cornette hadn't have been in peace, and I think that will be appealed, I think, but if he hadn't been in peace, that referee right there would have been fired. Well, how'd you get here anyway? How'd you end up here?
Well, I was asked to come in by the board of directors.
Who are they anyway? Are they nameless, faceless creatures?
Well,
are they real people or what?
Well,
what's
yes, they
the
are
deal,
real people.
Les?
They are real people, Dutch.
And they saw the way Jim Cornette was operating.
Well, they weren't happy the way the television program was being handled, nor some of the decisions. And
were they happy with me?
I think we saw with that match with Chris Candida, that's the type of thing that they were very disgusted with. But I don't know how you could be disgusted with a match like this, because you've got two of the top competitors in the country right here in this ring, Robert Gibson and a Dirty White Boy.
Well, you got one of them, the top competitors in the country. That's the Dirty White Boy. Robert Gibson, that's debatable. Now, see, and ask me why I say that. Just say, why do you say that, Dutch?
Why do you say that, Dutch?
Okay, why I say that. First of all, a good punch by Robert Gibson. He takes White Boy down. Now, I'm not taking anything away from Robert Gibson. He's a very good wrestler, but primarily, and you'll have to agree with me, primarily a tag team wrestler. So any measure of success only has to be judged with what he does really in tag team competition. He's always made his mark in professional wrestling in the tag team ranks, not the single ranks like the Dirty White Boy.
But if you don't mind a bit of a debate or the other side of the coin,
well,
of course, the Dirty White Boy also excelled at a tag team when his star was first on the rise in this sport.
Well, now look, that was years ago. That was years ago. We're talking about, I mean, that was then, and now is now.
Okay.
So things change. You know what I'm talking
about?
Yes,
they do.
Am I talking too fast for you,
like
Les?
Like commissioners and commentators. Dirty White Boy on top of this one.
Why did you bring it up? You just got to keep bringing it up, don't you?
Didn't mean to make you nervous, Dutch. You know, these two stars are just a portion of the great stars that are going to be on that Parade of Champions coming up in October.
And a good thing you mentioned that, because the Rock and Roll Express have promised the Armstrongs a title match and Parade of Champions. Now, there is more than meets the eye in that little encounter there. There's going to be there's something behind it, and I'm diligently searching to find that little speck of information that I need to sort of blow the lid off this thing.
I don't know if there's any hidden meanings, but it should be a great wrestling match.
Oh,
those
yeah,
two
I'm not
teams,
saying
I mean,
that. Oh,
should be holding counter
hold
right
down the
line.
It's going to be a great match, but what I'm saying is Ricky Gibson coming out here bumping those gums. Oh, it's going to be a clean match. It's going to be a scientific match. And I know Ricky Gibson. I've known him for years. And I know Scott Armstrong. I've known him for years. I can see the gleam of their eye, what they're
you
saying.
You mean Robert Gibson, Ricky's younger brother. You are nervous, Dutch.
I am nervous, but I was talking about Scott Armstrong. I can see the gleam in their eye. What's going on is they're sensing, well, if they make one mistake, we're not going to hesitate to really take advantage of it. And if it means punching somebody out, that's what's going to happen.
They're moving out of the way, trying to withstand this onslaught of the Dirty White Boy. Sends him in for the ride, meets him with the elbow coming off. Gibson needs to see if he can make this momentum count at this point. Big slam hammers him right down into the mat.
Gibson now hits those ropes coming off across the top. Let's see where he's going here with the shoulder block. Look here.
Wait a minute, we got some company. Oh, over the top, Tom Pritchard and Jimmy Del Rey out on taking Robert Gibson over the top rope onto the floor. And what a collision he had with that floor right there on that hardwood out there.
If he is
now, White Boy going in for the cover. Referee Mark Curtis, 1, 2, 3, new champion right here, Dirty White Boy. Taking the throne, taking the title from Robert Gibson and winning $1,000 for his efforts.
With the help, look here, the Heavenly Bodies pounding away on Ricky Morton, who has come out to aid his partner.
And look what he gets to come out there and help his partner. He's down like the egg-sucking dog that he is. And Jimmy Del Rey, Tom Pritchard, pounding on Ricky Morton on the floor. Now you see both rock and roll. What you're seeing right now, the Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions, both laid out face down in the mat.
But here comes Scott Armstrong with a chair. He chases the Heavenly Bodies off and saves Morton any further beating. And Robert Gibson getting up in the ring now.
He's attending to Ricky Morton right now. See him, Ricky's okay. Robert Gibson trying to come to his feet in the ring.
Gibson bails out to see him. Oh,
wait a minute. There it is. There it is. That's what I was telling you. Trouble brewing. Robert Gibson saw Scott Armstrong right there. Now they're arguing over, look at Armstrong saying, I didn't have anything to do with it, but it looked like to me, it looked like me, it looked like Armstrong was getting ready to pile drive.
Gibson got in the tail end of it, and he thought he'd stand over the chair, but I think it's just a misunderstanding, Coach.
Well, misunderstanding or not, still they've planted that seed already. Now, Scott Armstrong out there trying to be a little peacemaker, but he ends up
taken the brunt of the anger of the Rock and Roll Express.
But nonetheless, the Dirty White Boy ends up the winner with the help of the Heavenly Bodies.